stargazing on the shortest days of the year. Hey there, stargazers. I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory.
And I'm Marlene Hidalgo, science teacher from Miami-Dade County, Florida. Although you may have never thought about it before, for people who live at mid-northern latitudes across the U.S. and Europe, June is the month of the shortest nights for stargazing because at the time of the summer solstice, which this year is Friday, June 21st, hours of daylight are longest and hours of darkness are shortest.
In fact, for many people at mid-latitudes, it doesn't even get fully dark out until 10 or 11 o'clock, especially when you factor in daylight saving time. So let's do a quick preview of what you can see just after it starts to get dark out, if you live at mid-northern latitudes.
Okay, we've got our sky set up for June 10th after sunset facing north, where you may see the Little Dipper sticking straight up above the North Star. In fact, the North Star is the star in the end of the handle of the Little Dipper. Now, the Little Dipper is not nearly as large or bright as the Big Dipper, which is directly to its left in the northwest. Four stars mark its cup, and three stars mark its handle.
And once you've found it, you can shoot an arrow through the Big Dipper's handle to find the fourth brightest star in the sky, Arcturus, which is the major star of Bootes the Herdsman. Although, really, Bootes looks something like a kite.
You can extend that arrow from Arcturus to the brightest star of Virgo, Spica. Remember, arc to Arcturus, speed on to Spica. Near Spica, you're sure to spot a brighter bit of light. That's the ringed planet Saturn.
Now, we can tell from the stars alone that spring is almost over because spring's most famous constellation is above the western horizon. A sickle-shaped pattern or backwards question mark of stars mark the front part of spring's Leo the Lion, and a triangle of stars mark his rear. And he looks like he's getting ready to plunge below the horizon before summer kicks him out of the evening skies.
But there are several other bright objects for you to enjoy down to Leo's right on Monday night. The most obvious is a skinny, two-day-old crescent moon. To the right of the moon is brilliant Venus, and above Venus is Mercury. This is one of the best times this year to spot Mercury.
Now, Mercury is much dimmer than Venus, but if you watch over the next 2 weeks, Venus and Mercury will get closer each night. Here's the 12th, the 14th, the 16th, the 18th, the 20th. Venus keeps shifting farther left each night while Mercury drops steadily lower.
Next, if you turn around 180 degrees and face east, you can see three incredibly bright stars which mark the points of a very large triangle. The brightest is Vega, the second brightest Altair, and the third Deneb. The three stars which mark the points of the Great Summer Triangle. And every summer in mid-June, just after it gets good and dark out, we always see this triangle of three celestial dazzlers rising over the eastern horizon.
Of course, my personal favorite stars of summer are always somewhere in the south. So, if you look a little left of due south, you'll see a giant fishhook-shaped pattern of stars just rising above the horizon. It's summer's infamous Scorpius the Scorpion.
So even though these are the shortest nights of the year, you'll have no shortage of things to see in the night sky. Monday night the 10th, catch a skinny crescent moon beside Mercury and Venus. Venus will be in the western evening sky all summer long, but be sure to catch Mercury at its best evening viewing for the rest of the year, especially the nights of June 18th and 19th, when they'll be close side by side.
The summer triangle is coming into its own as one of the brightest star patterns of summer skies.
And don't forget Scorpius, Sagittarius, and the summer Milky Way. That will brighten up the southern skies as you keep looking up.